Vladimir Putin's army has succeeded in capturing just one regional capital, the city of Kherson. It was a key objective in the Kremlin's attempt to seize Ukraine's Black Sea coast. The eight-month occupation of Kherson ended in November when Ukraine's army forced the Russians to retreat back across the Dnipro River. But the city's residents are now under fire almost every day from enemy artillery positioned less than a mile away. We visited Kherson this month, and from what we witnessed, Russia's goal appears to be the destruction of what it cannot control. When we drove alongside the river, we didn't let the speedometer dip below 70 miles an hour. On one bank is the city. On the other, Russian tanks, artillery and snipers. A fast-moving target is hard to hit.
People in our city, they are the target. The enemy is crazy.
Halina Luhova used to be a school teacher and a city council member. Ukraine's president put Luhova in charge of rebuilding Kherson.
My working place?
Effectively, its mayor.
Добрий день.
We watched as she managed aid distribution, power outages, and an avalanche of problems caused by Russian shelling. Kherson has been shelled more than 2,000 times in the last 3 months.
Is there a pattern to what the Russians are hitting with the shelling, or is it random?
During a long period of occupation for 8 months, they know all the information as for our infrastructure. So they know everything.
Because they occupied the city, they know where the schools are. They know where the humanitarian aid points
are. Yes, they know.
Would you prefer it if all civilians left the city?
It will be better for them, I think. You know, our people go to bed every day and they don't know exactly if we'll be awake in the morning. It's really terrible.
Before the war, 300,000 people lived in Kherson. Now, about 60,000 remain. More than 80 people have been killed by the shelling. This fire station and 19 medical facilities have been hit. Nothing, it seems, is sacred. There's a bomb crater right outside the Church of the Exaltation of the Cross. Inside, it was below freezing. 84-year-old Valentina Sirik told us she was asking God to give the Russians common sense.
It's very dangerous in Kherson now. Why are you still here?
If you were this old, where would you go? She asked us. It's the elderly and those without the means to leave who have stayed.
That's where it landed, is that right?
We pulled up to this apartment building just hours after it took a direct hit. Irina Barandich was cleaning up the damage to her sister's apartment up on the fourth floor.
She's okay.
Nobody was hurt. Elena lives in one of only three apartments still occupied.
Why would they hit your building?
Because they simply want to annihilate Ukrainians, she said. What other reason could there be? They've grown used to cleaning up the debris in Kherson. But so much more has been shattered.
And with the war, it is almost no people here.
In English, we would call it a ghost town.
Katia Fativa has refused to leave Kherson, despite offers of a place to stay from friends outside Ukraine. Her son Max, who's 9 years old, started piano lessons last summer. Fativa told us it's been a good distraction because it's unsafe to go outside and play.